Hey, greetings. This is Brad from the Cheese Shop again. Today I'm going to do a video about a review of GURPS Tredroy. Tredroy is, let's see, I'll show it to you here. So it's an older source book based on the GURPS fantasy setting. Back when Steve Jackson created the GURPS fantasy, that's where information about his system Earth was created as well, and Tredroy is one of those cities inside of that fantasy setting of Earth. It was written by Alexander von Thorn and published in 1989, and it's a relatively small source book. It's only 64 pages long, so it is one of those books that maybe a little bit harder to find. You know, you can try Amazon, those kind of places, or maybe even your local game store may actually have it. To give you an idea of the source book itself, so it's broken up into a few things, and like all my other reviews, I'll just go through some of the table of contents and a little bit about each of them. So it talks about the history of Tredroy. So essentially, Tredroy is a commercial and industrial city. It overlaps three different countries. That's Al-Wazif, Cardiel, and Al-Haz. Together, it's actually separated by two rivers that come together. So there's a section up at the top and then also two sections down at the bottom. So it is, like I said, it's based in three separate countries. And there is a bridge that goes over each one of the actual rivers. So, but it is one large community of people. Tredroy itself means three laws. And essentially Tredroy is the city of three laws. There's over 500,000 people that actually live in the city and the surrounding area. And if you're familiar with anything on Earth, it's the majority of the religions are Christian and Muslims are the main face that are there. But there are also other faiths as well. So if your characters are doing more of a religious type sort of adventure or campaign, Tredroy is definitely a nice place to go if you have multiple players with different religions. So, one of the interesting things about Tredroy is because it is a city of three laws, is the laws section. And I mean, three laws are in effect. So each section has their own laws, and this actually leads to some interesting adventures and possibly plot hooks. You could, especially if you have characters that are going to be bounty hunters, this is a huge job in Tredroy, because someone could, you know, do a crime in Cardiel and then run across the bridge and get into Al-Haz. So the people in Al-Haz aren't going to prosecute them. So now you've got people that come from Cardiel to try to bring the person back, you know, depending on the crime. So there's tons of adventure hooks that you can think of just from a law standpoint. It's really an interesting place from that in that respect. And because Tredroy is a huge commercial and industrial city, there are a good deal of economics in the city. Essentially, there are all the guilds you could possibly think of are in Tredroy, you know, from assassin guilds, fighter guilds, mages guilds, merchants guilds, you know, fishermen's guilds, it all, you know, all the way down to, you know, maybe a small guild of guys that make clay pots or something like that. I mean, potter's guild, whatever. There's a ton of different guilds, and they all have their own influence within different parts of the city. So that could also be some good adventuring and plot hooks in there as well. There's a section in the book about people, and it really just goes over the main people in the city, you know, the people that that are basically in charge, people that are in charge of some of the larger guilds, that kind of thing. So there's also another section about the places of interest, which in the book is a good deal of information. It's their maps. So there's maps of all different places in Tredroy, and there's a lot of fluff with those places as well. So, you know, when they start talking about one of the guilds, they'll say who's in charge of the guild and kind of give you a background and a little bit of the history. So there is some fluff with the places of interest. So again, this whole book is a ton of information for plot hooks. The whole book is essentially fluff. And it just gives you a little bit more insight into the actual the continent of Earth, but also a little bit of how these three countries actually come together in this one spot. So you can imagine all of the different types of adventures and campaigns that the GM or even players would be interested in playing. The last thing that's on there in the book is it's an adventure called the Trail of the Serpent. So I'm not going to go into that. I mean, you know, so if you get the book and you want to run that actual adventure, so there is an adventure, even if you don't have, you just got the book, you know, it came in the mail and you're like, okay, it's time to run a game. You can just hop right on and, you know, just kind of thump through it and even go straight to the back and just give your players a little bit of history. But one of the important things about the book is it is one of my favorite source books for the fantasy. There's a couple of that I really like. But this one's really cool because there's so much that can happen in Tredroy. And I have in the past, in the early 90s, late 80s, run, even before the book was actually published, I'd actually run a few campaigns and adventures in Tredroy. And it's a ton of fun. I mean, there's a lot of information there. And it's easy to get lost in a big city, you know, over 500,000 people. So you can really... There's just so much role-playing opportunity there. So as a player, it's great. And as a GM, there's, you know, hook after hook after hook that you can give to the players. And what I found and what's really cool about going to Tredroy is that as a GM, if you don't have a good deal of planning done on your behalf, you can just start with something really simple and then just kind of let the players go in their own direction and then just kind of think of some things along the way and, you know, throw in front of them obstacles, things like that, and they can still have a ton of fun. And, you know, either be part of the big picture of Tredroy or just, you know, a small part or just passing through. So I definitely do recommend getting the book. I mean, it's obviously all of my reviews are from a fanboy perspective. I do try to get a little critical about some things, but for the most part, it's a really good book. I mean, I see it for what it is. So, and there's a ton of fluff. So Alexander Van Thorn, Von Thorn did a ton of good work on the book. So if you have an opportunity to actually pick it up, I highly recommend it. So as always, I appreciate you watching the video. And if you haven't already, visit my blog at thecheeseshop.org. And then down at the very bottom, I'm going to put a link to GURPS and also a link to where you can get this on Steve Jackson's website. Even though the book is out of print, you're still able to get the PDF on E23. And if you've been there to their store yet on Steve Jackson Games, you'll know what I mean by E23. So you can download the PDF. Like I said, it's a great little source book. And I think that you guys would have a ton of fun playing with it. So... thanks for watching, and I hope you guys have a good day.